The year 1957 is indelibly etched into the history of nuclear energy in the United Kingdom. Sellafield, formerly known as Windscale, is a nuclear facility located on the western coast of England in Cumbria. It was one of the first large-scale commercial nuclear facilities in the world. In October of that year, a severe accident occurred, having far-reaching consequences for both the environment and the nuclear industry. Causes of the accident. The primary cause of the accident was an uncontrolled reaction in one of the reactors, leading to the overheating of the graphite moderator. The reactor was designed to produce plutonium for the British nuclear weapons program, but its design was experimental and contained several flaws. Inadequate procedures and poor management, a cumulative effect of errors in reactor management, poor cooling, and improper temperature monitoring led to the temperature in the reactor core rising uncontrollably. Design deficits. The reactor lacked adequate safeguards against thermal fluctuations, exacerbating the situation in the event of any issues. Course of the accident. On October 10, 1957, the temperature in one of the reactors began to rise dangerously. Initially, operators thought it was a routine thermal fluctuation, but they soon realized the situation was serious. Overnight, they attempted to cool the reactor, but their efforts were unsuccessful. By October 11th, the temperature had reached such levels that the graphite moderator caught fire. The fire inside the reactor spread rapidly, and there was no effective way to extinguish it. As a result, large amounts of radioactive isotopes were released into the atmosphere. Response to the accident, evacuation and safety measures. Although the operators and engineers on site did everything they could to extinguish the fire, residents of surrounding areas had to be warned and evacuated. A safety zone was established around the facility to limit contamination, extinguishing the reactor fire. Ultimately, engineers managed to control the fire using a mixture of water and carbon dioxide, but by then, significant amounts of radioactive materials had already been released. Consequences of the accident: contamination and health impacts, radioactive isotopes, particularly iodine-131, cesium-137, and strontium-90, were released into the atmosphere, contaminating large areas. It is estimated that thousands of people were exposed to increased radiation doses, leading to a rise in cases of thyroid cancer and other health problems. Environmental impacts. Farmland and milk supplies were contaminated, leading to the destruction of significant agricultural production. Strict regulations and restrictions were imposed on the consumption of local produce. Political and industrial repercussions. The accident caused a fundamental shift in the UK's nuclear policy and led to a reassessment of safety standards in the nuclear industry. Stricter regulations were implemented, and safety procedures for all nuclear plants were improved. Conclusion. The Sellafield accident of 1957 was one of the worst nuclear accidents in the history of the United Kingdom. It had far-reaching consequences for human health, the environment, and the nuclear industry itself. While it led to improved safety measures and increased awareness of the risks associated with nuclear energy, it remains a stark reminder of how catastrophic the consequences can be when nuclear technology is not properly managed and controlled.